2015, on a Friday morning. And I said I was probably going to go to bed after the last one, because I just reacted to the live event. But the video I'm uploading only has like half an hour left, so I might as well just stay up so I can, you know, reset everything. And this match is Matt Ashley, some other guy. I don't remember who it is now. The Machine and
hey, guess what, pal?
Walton.
What? What do you got?
We're professional now.
Are you ready to do this?
I am so ready to do this.
Another Anarchy match. And I have Ashley and Durley with me.
We have 16 teams this year in the team tournament, the Ultimate Schmodown Team Tournament 2018. The theme is Anarchy. We're going to take competitors' names from a hat, draw them at random, and pair them up.
Alonzo Duralde, he's very good.
He's very
good. That's true.
And Matt Ashady.
You
know Matt Ashady?
He's good.
Yeah, formerly of MODOK.
No teams in their current state will be paired up. This is completely random. The winning team will play the current team champions at Spectacular 3. I have no further comments.
Don't count out the Machine. She's 2-0. She had two really solid matches.
She's all talk. Her wins. I don't even remember who they were against. All people, pretty sure. Just like Stacey. Well, Stacey's wins were against big people, but the Cougar and Mark Ellis. Mark Ellis is a big guy, but he already.
Welcome back to the movie trivia.
He's more of a commentator.
Anarchy, Ultimate Showdown.
Hey,
I'm Mark Ellis, and a little bit of back and forth in the crowd already, Christian. They are divided as to what the hell is going on, who they're going to be rooting for here today. But you and I present a nice united front announcing this match. And it's this whole league has gone into utter chaos, and it's neither one of our faults.
So all these teams that are coming around, they're all aiming for one thing, a shot at the Schmodown Spectacular against our current champions, the Shire Wolves. Clark Wolf and Rachel Cushing, they are the champions. They are waiting to see who's going to win this, and there are so many teams out here too. And these teams, this craziness has happened here because, first of all, you have Alonzo Duralde and Matt Ashady, who are the Paddington 2. Now, they've worked together before on What the Flick.
Paddington 2?
The Paddington 2.
Yeah, I would have gone with Ted 2. That's just me personally.
You're doing a TED Talk. The Paddington 2, and they are both experienced players. They're going up against the War Machine, which is Janine the Machine, who has gone through the ringer in this tournament in regards to who was going to be her teammate. At first, we thought it was Ethan Irwin. Then, because of either whether you believe it's scheduling or Mike Kalinowski had other plans, Ethan Irwin is not going to be her partner. And then Andrew Guy was supposed to be. Andrew Guy said, I do not want to work with Jay Washington, and took himself out of the tournament altogether. So now, who's Brian Walton? We don't know. Brian Walton, who is now the Warlord, took that moniker from Thad Williams, and he is now joining up. We don't know who the War Machine is.
Yeah, I mean, the name Brian Walton, pretty boring just on its face, but then you look at something like the Overlord, and you say, well, wait a minute, what is
who's
this
the Overlord?
Kid all about?
The Warlord.
What is the Warlord even better than Overlord? I mean, Overlord seems a little nasty. Warlord, nice guy, just likes to wreak havoc, and that's what we're going to get with the War Machine. But going up against Paddington 2, you talk about experienced players. Alonzo Duralde, one of the all-time all-time funniest people to sit next to during a horror movie. He
Raid
squeals.
2. The Raid 2 is funny, too.
He freaks out when he sees blood. Is there going to be any spilled here today? I have a feeling it's going to happen. I just don't know whose blood it is.
Well, we're going to find out a little how all the competitors are feeling in this first round matchup.
There's a lot of stickers on my laptop. I've got on my keyboard alone. I have Final Pilot sticker, Final Pilot sticker, My Broken Palace sticker, which is a basically Hotline website that my friends.
We are the Paddington 2. I'm El Rey de Navidad, Alonso Duralde.
And I am St. Matchy.
There we go. And we're here to compete in the tournament because we were randomly put together.
My whole front of my laptop.
This is supposed to be an easy thing for us going into this anarchy, right?
It was ridiculous.
It was supposed to be the machine. Anything Irwin. But then Kalinowski comes and does what he does. Runs to Thad. Thad plays his puppy. And now we don't have Ethan. So I decided to take a page out of the loud Hawaiian shirt wearing idiot Thad's book. They called you a warlord. No, that is not what you are. I'm going to introduce you to a real warlord. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up, Mr. Brian Walton, my warlord with the machine. You can call it a war machine. This is going to be beautiful.
Typically part of MODOK, the team formerly known as Team Tomato. I mixed up a little bit. Gray didn't get matched up with me in this particular tournament, but I'm lucky enough to be with Alonzo. I've known him for a while, and I'm still willing to do this with him. Alonzo's pretty smart. Not that Gray isn't, but I'm looking forward to this, and we're in full Christmas regalia because this man literally wrote the book on Christmas movies. I only hope some of that comes up today. Fingers crossed.
I know a lot of you are wondering, who is this guy? Who is he? Well, I'm going to tell you who I am. I'm the Warlord. I'm Brian Walton, and you're going to remember that name in this tournament. I'm going to deliver knockouts. I'm going to deliver TKOs. I'm going to earn extra points. I'm going to run circles around so many of y'all that you're going to wonder, oh my gosh, did I even know how to schmow down before this?
Look, like people think that nice gets last. That's not the case. I'm not afraid to spank some people that need it.
To quote the great Manolo Blahnik, heels were meant to be stepped on.
Ooh.
It may be my first match, but it's going to be one you're going to remember. You're going to want to remember it for the rest of the year, because at the end of this year, you're looking at the new team champions. And, little critique, boys, I'm really sorry to have to knock you out, but it matches your records.
The experience of Matt Atchity, he has been that close to being a team champion. The sudden death matchup against the Patriots last season, that close. He on the legendary team of MODOK. Now he is paired up with Alonzo, who had one match in teams, didn't go his way, but had a really strong showing in last year's free-for-all. Haven't seen him since. So will there be ring rust, or will he just simply, maybe he won't care because he knows Atchity so well? Then you have the machine. Janine the Machine has been up there in the conversation for Rookie of the Year. Again, became that close in the collision of almost beating Mark Andrako and Stacey Howard. Just didn't go her way, but this is her first match since then. She has already made a name for herself. It's Brian Walton. It's really about what he is going to do. If Brian Walton comes in here, does something like, say, Amara Kanopic does and has that rookie magic, then we could be looking at a strong team. Or will the lights get to him? Will he maybe not show up the way some other rookies have, and maybe it'll be too much? We just don't know yet.
Warlords tend to do their best fighting in the sunlight. They like to show off for their fellow man and woman, so I think the Warlord's going to be just fine. The Machine is she well-oiled, going up against the Paddington 2, two fellas who look great in Hawaiian shirts.
Well, we got the tail of the tape, starting with the War Machine. You have comic book movies, you have 80s movies, romantic comedies, and just being unknown. Is that a strength? We'll find out by the end of the match.
I don't believe that is a strength.
I don't know. We'll see. Then the Paddington 2, classics, Christmas movies, and Hawaiian shirts.
And marmalade. You got to give him marmalade.
I like it. All right.
From Argentina.
I'm ready to get going. How about you?
Yeah, I got it right.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the movie trivia showdown. Introducing first, led to the ring by their manager, the Urban Gladiator Jay Washington,
making their Schmodown team debut.
I'm paying attention. I'm browsing.
Shabashi and the Warlord Brian Walton. The War Machine. There's the Mortar Machine.
Excited
to be here. Janine the Machine clearly been here before, knows how to pose. And Walton happy to be getting up and around. And Jay Washington just seems to be amused by this whole match.
Thought I heard something. I don't think I heard anything. We're just going to continue.
Jay Washington is the only manager that actually is managing two teams in this tournament.
Well, good for him.
Yeah, so Jay Washington's managing two teams.
Making the big bucks.
And so now we are going to get their opponents. And their opponents. Welcome to my Christmas. Making their Schmodown team debut. The Kahuna, Matt Atchity, Alonzo Duralde, the Paddington 2! There's Alonzo and Matt.
Gonna say Merry Christmas Day.
Alonzo wrote the book on Christmas movies.
Alonzo did write a book on Christmas movies. Best ones to watch. He is wearing a Die Hard themed shirt. Matt Atchity looks like Santa Claus in January when he's on vacation in Hawaii.
Well, I think he was on vacation because he got here late. All right, here we go.
Unnecessary shot fired towards one of the competitors.
All right, here we go. Let's get into round number one, Mark. How's that work?
I will read the rules in round one while Christian gets whatever's wrong with his ear situated. In round number one, the field is going to hear eight questions from eight different movie categories. Keep in mind this is a team match, but you are not allowed to rely on the knowledge of your teammate. In round one, the question is asked to the individuals. Each question is worth 1 point. There is no penalty for missing a question. There is no stealing in round one. As soon as one of us asks the question, please, each of you, write down your best attempt at the correct answer on the whiteboard in front of you. When we call you by your name after about 15 seconds, please show what you wrote down to the camera. At the same time, you verbalize your best attempt at an answer into the microphone. And I will remind each team that you have 3 usages of the JTE rule at your disposal. If you need to hear a question again, you weren't sure you heard it right, or you need to buy yourself some time, use the JTE rule. Each team gets 1 challenge. And with that, Christian, your ear is unclogged and we are ready to go.
Yep. All right, so with that, Paddington 2, are you guys ready?
Yes.
War Machine, are you ready?
Yep.
Then let's get ready to Schmodown!
There it is. Your first question. Field is in the world of fantasy science fiction. And your question is, who directed 1996's classic Independence Day?
I remember that movie coming out. Phenomenal. People could not stop talking about that.
Before the superhero movie really popped.
It's a good holiday as well.
4.
Yeah, it's true. 3. You're a griller.
2. Firecrackers.
A lot of grilling. 1.
Pens down, please. Pens down. And Alonzo.
Roland Emmerich.
Correct. Janine.
Roland Emmerich.
Got it, Matt.
Roland Emmerich.
And Brian.
That's that boy, Roland Emmerich.
He got it. All right. Side now. Look at that. 2-2. Flag one coming to play. Here's your second question. In the category of crime films.
Stick them up.
What Guy Ritchie film features Tom Wilkinson, Thandi Newton, and Gerard Butler?
I believe I can find 2 phrases there. I think put them up is what you take the rocks on. And a stick up is the act of criminals.
Oh, but you made it up. You made it your own. 5. 4.
Used to play stick ball.
3. 2. 1. Pens down, please. And Janine.
Didn't have it.
Didn't have it. Matt.
Rock and Rolla.
Correct. Brian.
Didn't have it.
And Alonzo.
Rock and roll.
They had it. 4-2. 4-2. Paddington 2 going up by 2.
Jay Washington, the manager. And I would also remind Brian Walton, he seemed crestfallen. It's just one.
He didn't seem very sad. Okay. Just lost the title or something.
I wanted that extra point, man.
I understand.
We all want things in life. And Paddington 2, perfect through 2 questions. Your next one comes in the world of dramas. And that query is, what 1999 drama movie follows an 18-year-old girl in the 1960s who is committed to a woman's mental institution and also had an actress win Best Supporting Actress Oscar?
Do you have any friend's name Oscar?
Oh, Oscar Mayer has been one of my best friends.
Not a comment, but not a real name. Five, four,
are you saying my baloney friend isn't
three,
real?
Two, one, pens down. Matt Atchley.
Girl Interrupted, also known as Kiss Your Brother at the Oscars.
You got it. Brian. Brian.
Girl Interrupted.
Yep, you got it. Alonzo.
Girl Interrupted.
Janine.
Girl Interrupted.
Hey, everybody had a 6-4. Paddington 2 looking really good here so far. And what's our next question here?
Watch that's me. Day,
animated. Animated.
Same
what studio Ghibli film features a living scarecrow sidekick named Turniphead?
I bet that's what all the kids used to call you in school.
Turniphead?
Oh, here comes Turniphead Harlow.
Yeah. I'm going to be honest.
Did I hear your
Did you hear my feeling? No, I was trying to figure out what the hell Ghibli is.
You seem like Brian Walton when he misses a question.
Five, four, three, two, one. Pens down. Brian.
Kiki's Delivery Service?
That's incorrect. Alonzo?
Nausicaa?
Incorrect. Janine?
Frankenweenie?
No. And Matt?
Spirited Away?
No. Looking for Howl's Moving Castle. Howl's Moving Castle. That's a tough first rounder, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, they all had different guesses. Wagering something, none of them right. Your next question comes from the world of action-slash-adventure films. What 1973 movie stars Bruce Lee as a martial artist recruited to spy on a drug lord during a deadly fighting tournament?
Love this movie.
I can tell.
I love it.
How inspired you were. When
they
I
remake
said
it. I want to break kneecaps. Five. I think they are. Four.
I'm gonna kick myself for not
turn of heads upset, everybody.
Two,
I feel like Bruce Lee's always
one.
A
pens
artist.
Down, please. And Alonzo.
Enter the Dragon?
Yes, sir. Janine.
Didn't have
no,
it.
Matt.
This is not a charade. Enter the Dragon.
Yes, Brian.
This is Enter the Dragon.
You got it. Okay, but Janine missed. Now they have a 3-point deficit here. And we get to our next
underrated actually.
Comedies is the category. Which classic comedy features the quote, "Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son"?
It actually is a way to go through life, and I live by that mantra every day.
You did it.
Still do it. On the inside. On the inside.
I'm looking at these. You're not too drunk. Five.
How you doing?
Four. Three.
I'm not
two,
sure. If this is
one. Pens down. Janine.
Didn't have it.
Matt.
Dean Wernher says that in Animal House.
That is correct. Brian.
I don't need to tell you who said it just to be clever. Animal House.
And Alonzo.
He says it to Flounder in Animal House.
There you go. 10-6 now. 10-6. Okay. 10-6, and the War Machine is down by 4. Next question, Mark.
Horror thriller is your penultimate category in round number 1. And the question is, who wrote, directed, and starred in the 2015 film The Gift?
They're giving me a gift. No, but
I don't know the girl lead, but Jason Bateman.
I will. You earned it.
You're the lead in that.
4.
I'm going with him. On Christmas
okay,
Day.
2. 1. You know my address. Pens down, please. And Matt Atchley.
I know he played Owen Lars.
Oh, that's incorrect.
Oh,
Brian.
Boy.
To get a point here. Brian.
Shyamaland, spelled wrong.
No. And Alonzo.
Joel Edgerton.
Correct.
Joel Edgerton.
Oh, there you go. So 11-7. Staying within 4 here. But now we get to our 8th question, our 8th final question. It is a Patreon question, and the following question comes to you from Jonathan Peck. Thank you, Jonathan, for supporting the show and being a patron.
Thank you, Jonathan. Thank you for all your tweets on Movie Talk as well.
In the category of the 2010s, Jonah Hill and Miles Teller star in what Todd Phillips film about gunrunners?
You know, you're not on Movie Talk much these days. You hear this Todd Phillips is doing this Joker movie.
Yeah.
It's like an independent thing.
Five.
Joaquin. Mark Maron's in it.
3. I like that. 2.
Good.
1. Pens down, please. And Brian Wong.
War Dogs?
You're a war dog now, man.
Correct. Alonzo.
War Dogs.
Yes. Janine.
War Dogs.
And Matt.
Not War Inc.
Oh, he missed it. So they're only down by 3 here. That was a big miss by Matt Atchley.
Yeah, Santa Claus went on vacation a little early in that round, and it is only a 3-point lead
good
for Paddington 2.
Good round.
They were very dominant early on. War Machine hanging around, and they are still well within range in this game as we get into round number 2, the wheel round, the wheel of destiny, fate, perhaps justice for one team. On the wheel are 10 categories from 10 different corners of the movie Trivia Schmodown Galaxy. We also have the fan favorite spinner's choice and every competitor's dread opponent's choice. Each team is going to get one spin at the wheel. If you don't like what you spin at first, you are allowed one mulligan, and you will spin the wheel again, at which point you must select whichever category you get. There's going to be 6 questions per category. Each question is worth 2 points. If you're not sure of the answer of a question, you can ask us to give you multiple choice. We'll give you 4 options. One of them is correct, and that reduces the value of the question to 1 point. Keep in mind, competitors, there is stealing available in round number 2. So if you or your teammate can't get the question right, maybe somebody on the other side of the table will, and they will accrue the points. No penalty for missing a question in round number 2. Christian and 2 of the wheel slices on that wheel are sponsored by our patrons. The movie Trivia Schmodown Patreon. Check it out today. The sponsored wheel slices today are Tom Hanks and Leonardo DiCaprio. Somebody loves Oscar-winning actors.
Well, that is true. Now, both of you guys have all of your JTE rules. You have both your challenges. And we are going to ask the Paddington 2 if they would like to go first or second.
We'll go first.
You're going to go first. All right, Matt, go ahead and give it a spin. Please do not spin the wheel by the peg. Please spin it by the wheel itself. And here we go.
Oh, I just thought of something adorable. What if the actual Paddington Bear was to attempt to spin the wheel? What kind of hijinks would we get into, you know?
Yeah. Here we go.
Because he wouldn't do it, right.
There's the spin by accident.
Spin.
Good spin. All right.
There's...
It spun around. It
looks like the wheel has been lubed with marmalade.
It went around, and then we're going to land on...
2,000. It could be DiCaprio. Do you want to keep DiCaprio?
I'm going to go all day.
Once. Okay.
Spinning away from Leo.
Not so much. No, no.
Saw DiCaprio one time at the pizza place Joe's Pizza on Sunset.
I love that.
Yeah. DiCaprio and a number of his friends was not invited back to their hangout. Here it comes. We could be looking at another DiCaprio adventure, even Spinner's Choice.
Cate Blanchett.
Okay.
Cate Blanchett. Yeah. There it is. All right, Cate Blanchett. Mark, you want to go ahead and...
I will. I will ask the Cate Blanchett questions.
All right.
Do you know Cate Blanchett?
I know it's pronounced Blanchett.
Ooh.
Oh.
She said so on Ellen.
Did she really? All right. Cate Blanchett.
is it Blanchett Cate. Or Blanchett?
Blanchett, they said.
Blanchett? All right. Cate B is the category. And your first
I'm
question
I'm a gay man.
Is,
I know things about Cate Blanchett.
This is your first of 6. Cate Blanchett plays a frontier medicine woman who must align with her estranged father when her daughter is kidnapped in what Ron Howard Western thriller?
Can we get multiple choice, please?
I can provide that. Is it A, The Missing, B, Wild Country, C, Abducted, or D, Frontier?
Frontier, something.
A, The Missing.
1 point there for the go. Paddington 2.
All right.
The crowd has to be prompted to clap. Some of them do, in fact, care about those competitors. Your next question. Who starred alongside Cate Blanchett as Hannah's father in the film Hannah?
I'm sorry, could you repeat, please?
That's one repeat.
Who starred alongside Cate Blanchett as Hannah's father in the film Hannah?
Multiple choice, please.
Is it A, Carl Urban, B, Thomas Jane, C, Eric Bana, or D, Brad Pitt?
C, Eric Bana.
1 point. They're negotiating their way around KP's category nicely.
Yep.
Your next question for the Paddington 2. What actress did Cate Blanchett portray in Martin Scorsese's film, The Aviator?
Katharine Hepburn.
There's a 2-pointer, and it's 16-9, halfway through the Paddington 2's round number 2. Next question. What veteran actor portrays Cate Blanchett's blind father-in-law, Sir Walter Loxley, in Ridley Scott's Robin Hood?
We'll need a multiple choice, please.
And I will have it for you. Is it A, Max von Sydow, B, Christopher Lee, C, Ian McKellen, or D, Christopher Plummer?
I believe it's A, Max von Sydow.
You believe correctly. Keep the faith. 17-9.
Yeah.
2 more questions. Your next one.
I'd like to wake up the audience, if possible.
That was an odd time to wake them up.
Yeah, I know.
Who directed Cate Blanchett in 2014's The Monuments Men?
George Clooney.
2 points.
Yeah.
And their last question in the world of Cate Blanchett movies. Name the film from the synopsis. Tragedy strikes a married couple on vacation in the Moroccan desert, touching off an interlocking story involving four different families.
Babel.
It is, in fact, Babel, and that's two more points. Wow. And all of a sudden, it is 21-9. Christian, that's the kind of thing that can happen in the team format. You can get a giant lead if you go first in round number two.
Now, the War Machine has a chance,
I believe
though.
It's pronounced Babel.
So if the War Machine hits something they're good at here, they got a chance because they use multiple choice a couple different times. But,
absolutely.
But they can also find themselves in some serious trouble.
The more experienced of the two War Machines, Janine,
right, go.
Is
going to
be
there.
Spinning the wheel.
Yeah. All right.
A good spin.
There is the spin. The crowd cheering her on, as is her manager, Jay Washington. Jay Washington, proud of the spin, not necessarily rooting for a particular category. Is it going to be 2000?
Oh, 2000.
It is.
2000. Brian's saying he's good with it.
Right, Brian's
good
with
so
it.
Short.
Looks like.
Okay, they're going to stick with 2000. That's good teamwork there. All right. Okay, here we go, guys. 2000s. 2000. Six questions in the world of 2000. Here's your first one. Who plays the character of Patrick, who tries to steal Clementine away from Joel in 2004's Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind?
The third freaking lead is our question? I can't remember the third lead.
Five.
Multiple choice.
A, Mark Ruffalo. B, Elijah Wood. C, Jake Gyllenhaal.
Elijah
D,
Wood.
Tom Wilkinson.
B, Elijah Wood.
Correct for 1 point. Who plays Bella's first friend, Jessica Stanley, in Twilight?
I don't know.
Anna Kendrick.
2 points.
Yeah. Really? They knew the Twilight question right away, Christian. Yep. You got to question their taste.
All right. In Almost Famous, William's first writing assignment is to review a concert by which popular rock band?
Stillwater?
It's incorrect. For the steal?
Can we get multiple choice? Allman Brothers?
It's Black Sabbath.
Has he lost his mind?
Yeah, all right, next question here. All right.
They're on my first time.
In The Hurt Locker, who played Staff Sergeant Matthew Thompson, who was killed by IED at the very beginning of the film?
It's Eric Bana. Eric Bana.
It's incorrect.
Guy Pearce.
2 point steal.
Yes. Oh, that's a giant steal. We have two questions left for them to answer, and they're going to have to get some right here, Chris.
All right. Who voiced the lead rat in Ratatouille?
Patton Oswalt.
2 points. Okay.
Big answer there that cuts the lead to single digits.
All right, here is the last question.
I was going to say Patton,
all right.
And then I was going to struggle.
In Avatar, who plays the corporate administrator for the RDA mining operation?
I don't remember that guy's name. He's short.
Giovanni Ribisi?
2 points.
In danger of a knockout for a time there. War Machine fighting back with those last two questions. 7-point lead. Now, look, clearly Paddington 2 would be the favorites to win at this juncture, but we have seen crazier things happen, especially in a tournament format, especially when that tournament is called Anarchy.
Well, Anarchy is underway, and we are ready for round number 3. Mark, how does it work?
In round number 3, each team is going to give us a series of numbers that can range from 1 to 20. Each one of those numbers corresponds to a different movie trivia schmodown category up here at the answer desk. The first question the team receives is worth 2. The next question, 3. The last one, should we make it that far, 5 points. Keep in mind, teams, the 5-pointer is the only question where you are allowed to consult with your teammate. Once we give you the category for the 2-pointer, the team must decide which member is going to answer that alone. The opposite member will then have to answer the 3-point question. Because the Paddington 2 is currently in the lead by 7 points, we'll hear your 3 numbers first and reserve them just for you.
14.
Okay, limited time.
19.
I'm fully in.
7.
14, 19, and 7 for Paddington 2, and for the War Machine?
3.
9.
15.
3, 9, and 15 for the War Machine. All right, so the winner of this match will go on to play the winner of Scott Manson Gerber or Andrejko and Snyder, but we're going to find out here who's going to win this match as we start with the War Machine, who picked Category number three for your first category.
Hmm.
Category number three.
I wonder what category that corresponds to, Christian.
That would be Kate Blanchett. All right, so
it's
the
pronounced Kate.
Two-pointer. Who's going for it?
I'll take it.
All right, Brian is going to go for it. Who directed Kate Blanchett in the 2015 version of Cinderella?
Kenneth Branagh.
2 points.
All right.
You need all these.
All right, so Janine is now up here. Janine has number nine. Number nine, Janine, and that's Nicole Kidman. It's Nicole Kidman.
Kidman.
All right. Nicole Kidman plays a villainous taxidermist in what family film?
Paddington.
Correct.
It's funny. Okay, Kevin, USAA Bank is here to help you stay on track. Lots of irony in these categories and these questions.
USAA Bank helps you stay a step ahead. Find help at every turn with USAA Bank.
And somehow, I
golf
believe
clap.
Paddington escaped that
golf clap.
Otherwise, their team name would not be called the Paddington
right.
2.
So, to take their first lead and to stay in the game, they need to hit the 5. However, if they miss it, Paddington 2 will play the winner of Snyder and Draco or Mance and Gerber. Here we go. Romance films. Romance films are your category. In the film Paper Towns, who plays Margot, who is the teen that disappears? In Paper Towns, who plays Margot, the teen that disappears?
I don't think it's me.
5, 4.
Can you please repeat the question?
Second repeat. In Paper Towns, who plays Margot, the teen that disappears?
They have one more usage.
5. They have one more, yeah. 4, 3.
Divinier?
No, wait.
1. And your winners! By way of technical knockout, the Paddington! Cara Delevingne, they had it on. They knew who it was. Yeah. Tip of their tongue. Maybe, again, maybe that's the rookie mistake. Maybe taking that last JT, they would have.
You see the veteran competitors spend all their JT rules if they know it. It seemed like the war machine was sounding it out. But take nothing away from Paddington 2. Paddington 2 will be moving on. Matt Atchity and Alonzo Duralde, they clearly know a lot about movies. But war machine, if this isn't the last we see of them, I would not be shocked because they really played well together.
They did play well together. Well, I think that Brian
Hell of a beard. And the machine is just a brawler, man. She is someone who just is here to scrap. You can tell she hit a three-pointer when she needed to. She's a good fighter here. So we're going to have both those competitors back. Jay Washington's first
is no longer in
the
me,
tournament, but he'll be back as well. The Paddington 2 now moves on. They will play the winner of Scott Mance and Gerber Orr and Draco and Snyder.
That is going to happen in round number 2 of the tournament. Now we're going to go to Jen Sturger, who is with both the War Machine and the Paddington 2. Here we go.
With the Paddington 2, it's the, right?
The. No,
the
Blanchett.
Blanchett.
Okay. Well, regardless, actually, it's great seeing you back in the winner's circle. You were
good. Yeah,
commenting back here to me. You're like, oh, my God.
Yeah, it's nice to win one. I guess the difference is not doing a couple of shots ahead of time. Maybe.
You were a little more on your game today. Yeah. And we haven't seen you in a year and a half. It's been a while since you've competed. And I felt like you guys kind of came out of the gate swinging.
Yeah, I think I'm a footnote at best in this whole thing. But this was a blast. And Matt and I have worked together for years at What the Flick. We know what each other knows and doesn't know. And that seems to help.
And don't sell yourself short, Alonzo. You're at least a foot and a half note.
Oh, my God. But no, you're off to a good start. But were you a little bit surprised at playing against War Machine, like how well they did and came back in the last round?
Yeah, that second round they did really well. We had pulled far ahead, but they hit a lot of those questions as two-point answers.
But you had a phenomenal steal.
Yeah, that was. I think that made a big, big difference. So that was fun. You know, the Eric Bannett, like, yeah, he doesn't die at the beginning of Black Hawk Down. He dies at the end. So I'll give Walton a little bit of crap about that. But they put on a good one. You know, I think they'd forgotten they had one more JTE rule to use, but I'm not sure they would have pulled it out anyway because we still had three questions. So we hadn't even answered that final round.
Yeah, we were not afraid to be in that final round. But, you know, as it turns out, we didn't have to.
You know, there's been all this talk about super teams, and there's super teams that have been created in this Anarchy tournament, and I don't really feel like anyone's giving you guys the credit you may deserve.
I'm not sure I was giving ourselves the credit, but after today, I've realized it. You know, part of why we're in Christmas attire is that Alonzo literally wrote the book on Christmas movies. And, you know, I see Alonzo every week and we talk movies, and it's one of those things, you know, he's doing stuff at Filmstruck. Like, I forget, oh, right, Alonzo knows movies. I mean, look, all of us in this league do, but there's people that you look at and think, oh, that guy's got untapped knowledge. And so what I'm going to say to everybody else in this tournament, watch out, because I got a ringer here and I know how to get it out of him, and it's going to be awesome. And yeah, I said that inappropriately, and it's okay because we work together and it's cool.
That's true.
All right. So now, obviously, you're going to wait and see who you're playing next. It's either going to be Manson Gerber or Snyder and Andrako. Do you have a preference on either of these teams that you'd like to face?
I think Manson Gerber, that'll be a better match. In Snyder and Andrako, you know, Snyder, that's an empty chair.
Oh, ouch. I used to work with Snyder at the Wrap. I've known Andrako for years. I've known Mance for years. So, you know, bring it.
Guys, I'm here with the War Machine and Jay Washington. Janine, can you? Yeah. Thanks.
Hi.
Janine, obviously that didn't go the way you guys wanted it to.
Yeah, he assumed that we used all the JTE rules. I think if we had known we had the third one, we would have got there. We were so close. We almost had it.
Obviously. And then round two, you spun 2000s. And honestly, like, I feel like that's a category you normally would be good at. And it just, you just fell short in that category. Were you surprised at the difficulty of it?
Yeah. I mean, it's really broad. You think it's going to be maybe early stuff and stuff that's newer, so you might know it. But it's super broad because it could be so many movies.
And how did you feel, obviously, going into that last round? You know, I think you forgot how many JT rules you had or hadn't used.
You know, I got ahead of myself. I got in there. I knew that I could punch strong, but I kind of got overwhelmed. I thought we had a little bit more time. Hearing them counting down, I thought I had used three, and just we were almost there.
And it was on the tip of your
tongue. Yeah, Devigné, Delavigne. Isn't that how they pronounce Delavigne in France?
I don't think she knows.
It's the horrible girl from Suicide Squad and Valeria.
Anyways, Jay, obviously, you know, this is the end for War Machine in the tournament, which is, we were hoping they would go further. You're actually crying. And now you still have Ethan Irwin and Savina Graves going on to the next, you know.
All I can do is put money in a wishing well, find a rabbit's foot, or some type of leprechaun, because this whole Kalinowski thing is horrible. Oh, God.
Look, they're gone. Sabine and Ethan still in this. No matter what, it is all going to be all right. I give a damn less about the Anarchy theme. I give a damn less about Kalinowski. And I give a damn less about the Paddington 2. So you know what? This interview is done. Go to your next one.
Must have been allergies.
Well, obviously, not obviously, the Paddington 2 saying that, you know, I think that they want to play Andrako and Snyder there,
yep,
too, because Alonzo knows Andrejko pretty well, and the Snyder obviously has some past history with Atchity, so it would make sense they'd want them to win, but you know, don't count out Scott Mantz ever.
Well, yeah, perhaps I was going to say they just don't want their ears to bleed because Scott Mantz gets very loud and very excitable,
match
could go either way, and this one really could have too. I mean, it came down to a five-pointer, not the last five-pointer, because Paddington 2 would have had questions to answer as well, but a very solid TKO, good performances by both teams, and again, this is what happens in a tournament like Anarchy. The teams get thrown together haphazardly. I thought we saw some good chemistry on display. Not just with the competitors, but with us here at the announcing desk.
I agree with that. I think Giralda and Atchity, though, these are two seasoned critics. I mean, these guys know their shit, and you could tell, and they know each other very well. They played together well. Atchity is now a veteran of this league. Mm-hmm. Alonzo is still fairly new to this league, but he was cool, calm, and collected the whole entire time. They're a scary team. No one's really talking about the Paddington 2 in regards to, well, everyone's talking about, you know, the big teams that are the super teams that have been put together, and no one's talking yet about these guys. These guys are a super team.
Well, like when people didn't talk about the first Paddington, it became a box office juggernaut because that damn bear is so freaking adorable. Make sure you guys check out the movie, Trivia Schmodown, Patreon. Check it out today and select which tier is right for you. We always appreciate your support of the show. Check out the Schmodown Rundown as well as the movie, Trivia Schmodown, Facebook page. I'm Mark Ellis.
Yeah, and he's going to go down this month. That's right. He and I are going head-to-head, five-round battle. You can only get it on Patreon. That's right. It's an exclusive match. Not going in the record books, but it is going down in history.
Going
as that
in this
match.
Record book.
You want it to see myself versus Ellis. You want it, go to the Patreon. Go become a patron today. Thank you guys for joining us. It is Schmodown. It is Anarchy, and we are underway.
Carrots are going to be chopping him.
How's it going, guys? If you didn't know about the Patreon, you guys have a chance to...
It went down exactly how I expected it to. And Walton did surprise me, the Brian Walton guy. Janine, and she knows some stuff, but it's nothing impressive. Not to me anyway. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know if I told you guys, but I got, if I were the Paddington 2, I would have 1 point, and if I were the War Machine, I would have 2. So, I'm not impressed by any means, but I'm actually going to go to sleep now. But, this has been fun, it's been great, and yeah, that's all I really got to say. I mean, I've kind of been watching Atchity from the beginning when he first started, and I knew he was good. So, I didn't sleep on him. I feel like there's more I should say here, but, well, bye guys, have a great day.